हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस टॉपिक ऑफ जॉय एंड चैलेंजेस ऑफ बीइंग ए सिविल इंजीनियर हैज बीन डिलीवर्ड बाय मी एट सेवरल इंस्टीट्यूट्स एंड इट हैज बीन लाइक्ड बाय स्टूडेंट्स, सो आई थॉट ऑफ शेयरिंग इट ऑन यूट्यूब आल्सो। द वर्ड सिविल इंजीनियरिंग वाज कॉइंड इन 18th सेंचुरी बाय जॉन स्टीमॉन to differentiate the work for military and not military purpose. Therefore, it is considered to be the oldest profession, and it deals with the design, construction and maintenance of structures or public works as they are related to earth, water or space. Civil engineering is also known as mother of all engineering, and I always abbreviate this civil as challenge is very important in life. If you make a Google search, you will find several challenging projects which have been completed by civil engineers around the world, be it a project of building or flyovers or canals, bridges over water or dams. It can be highways and tunnels through extremely difficult terrain. In case of bridges, the Golden Gate Bridge, which was constructed in 1933, until 1964, it was the longest suspension bridge. It has now been surpassed by 15 bridges, including one in the New York City. Longest is now in Japan, with a central span of 1,991 meter. Say, this world's busiest and the biggest cantilever bridge, Howrah Bridge, which was also constructed during the same period in 1943, it serves as the gateway to Kolkata, connecting it to the Howrah station. And it is the sixth longest cantilever bridge in the world. It's a huge structure, but without a nut and bolt. It is formed by riveting the entire steel structures. If you look at the cable stayed bridge, the tallest cable stayed road bridge is in France, one of the most impressive engineering ventures in the world, and it is the 12th highest bridge in the world. The longest bridge, cable stayed bridge in India, which was inaugurated very recently in 2017, it is 1.4 kilometer long, four lane bridge over the river Narmada in Gujarat. Pamban Bridge, a railway bridge, opened on 24th February 1914, and it was the India's first sea bridge and was the longest sea bridge in India until the opening of the Bandra-Worli sea link in 2010. It's a rail bridge, and for the most part a conventional bridge resting on concrete piers, but has a double leaf bascular section midway which can be raised to let ships and barges pass through. That is the beauty of this bridge. Tunnels, we have made in India, that is the longest railway tunnel of 11 kilometer, located in Pir Pranjal range of Middle Himalayas in Jammu and Kashmir, and which is the second longest railway tunnel in Asia, and with operating speed of 75 kilometer per hour. On the left side, I have taken a photograph from world, and the right side, it is parallel in India. Burj Khalifa, which is made in Saudi Arabia, it is 830 meter high structure. Bandra-Worli sea link, one of the India's largest overwater bridge. It was created to address the traffic congestion between Bandra and Worli in Mumbai. It is 5.6 kilometer long, one of its kind, and it took almost 10 years to make and now caters to over 100,000 vehicles. Narmada Canal Solar Project, which is the world's first canal top solar power plant in Mehsana, Gujarat. Chenab Bridge, which is the highest bridge in the world, 359 meters above the river bed. Airport terminals at Delhi, world's best airport, handling 25 to 40 million passengers per annum, and is South Asia's largest aviation hub. It also has India's first automated parking management and guidance system in a 7-level car parking area, and which can accommodate 4,300 cars. Agra-Lucknow Expressway on the right side, it is the longest expressway in the country now. It has surpassed Yamuna Expressway, which was longest expressway before opening of this in 2017. It is 302 kilometer and it is 165 kilometer long. But this is 6-lane and this is a 4-lane. Bogiebil Bridge over Brahmaputra, it is the longest road cum rail bridge in India. It is double decker, 4.94 kilometer, and this is the first bridge to have fully welded steel concrete support beams that can withstand earthquakes of magnitude up to 7 on the Richter scale.
There can be numerous examples of excellence and advancements in civil engineering. Today, civil engineering has gone to the extent that an architect draws a figure which is pleasant to the eyes, and civil engineer design it which is safe and long lasting. Civil engineering is linked to knowledge of converting people's dream into reality, and that is the joy. All structures which I have shown to you in my previous slides are designed and constructed by a civil engineer. The real joy comes on the day when you drive on a road which was made by you, when you stand on a bridge designed and constructed by you, when a multiplex is inaugurated and dedicated to the nation, the kind of satisfaction, the kind of joy you draw from all these projects is incomparable. Now, major disciplines of civil engineering are 6, but each of these areas have changed drastically in last 3 to 4 decades. And today it is believed that there are 13 disciplines of civil engineering. The structural engineering, which is the backbone of civil engineering, it has several challenges now. Low-cost housing and prefabricated structures. Low-cost housing is a new concept which deals with effective budgeting and following of the techniques which can reduce the cost of construction, maybe by making use of waste materials or local materials without sacrificing the strength and performance of the structure. Prefabricated structures are required in emergency like earthquakes, floods or other pandemic situations, and you might have read in newspapers how China made hospitals in 10 days to fight with corona cases. CSIR CBRI Roorkee has also made one prefabricated hospital in Ghaziabad, UP very recently. Similarly, uncertainty in structural engineering. Accurate modeling of seismic loads remains one of the great challenges. Reliable strong motion data are very limited in the country, and similarly, physics of aging process of structures needs to be understood. Condition assessment and health monitoring of structures is another challenge, and there are almost 98 lakh bridges in India, and most of these bridges, health assessment has become one of the most neglected areas of operation. This is a huge challenge for civil engineers now. There are railway bridges which are more than 100 years old, and running of the trains with proper speed and safety is another challenge. Strengthening and rehabilitation of these bridges require use of latest technologies for their health assessment. Structures like reactor plants need to be designed for fire and blast. The strategy for dealing with blast-induced threats against a structure requires attention from planning and design stage itself, because introducing or altering various blast response mitigation strategies becomes either difficult or impossible later on. Wind engineering is now an entirely new subject. The American Society of Civil Engineers convened a national meeting in 2016 on the future of wind engineering to discuss emerging and trending topics. And the reason for this increased interest in wind engineering stems from the globally escalating loss of property during extreme wind events. A wide variety of civil structures is made with reinforced concrete, like bridges, tunnels, marine structures, sewer systems, or dams. In fact, concrete is the world's most used man-made material. Now, researchers who have analyzed and practical cases of premature deterioration of our structures have found that in 70% to 90% of the evaluated cases, corrosion was the dominant degradation mechanism. Now, this is called Mobile Bridge Inspection Unit. It has been designed in one of the CSIR labs, and it is used to take distress data of different members of a bridge. It is possible to go below the deck slab also using this unit. It has now become mandatory in all NHAI projects to use this unit to monitor bridges on all national highways. Similarly, there are several types of coatings available in the market that are used on reinforcing bars to reduce the corrosion, but their efficacy is still to be explored in real life situation. Corrosion is a major problem in coastal regions, not only in India but in other countries as well, and it is estimated that almost $2.5 trillion are lost due to corrosion worldwide, and this number does not include individual safety or environmental consequences. This is nearly 3.4% of the global gross domestic product, and you can imagine how massive the problem of corrosion is. Another important challenge in structural engineering is to conserve the natural resources, and therefore the engineers are now looking for green concrete. It is a revolutionary topic in the history of concrete, and it was first invented in Denmark in year 1998. It is a type of concrete which is much like the conventional concrete, but the production of such concrete requires minimum amount of energy and it causes least harm to the environment. Now, geopolymer concrete is another form of green concrete, and the target is to reduce the energy consumption in making the concrete. Another big challenge before structural engineers today is conservation and restoration of heritage structures, and it is important not only from historical perspective but also from tourism, employment and economic growth. Central Building Research Institute, Roorkee, is involved in restoration of a few of these sites, but this is a huge research and implementation problem. Another big challenge before civil engineers today is to enhance the capacity of railway bridges to move heavier freight by Indian Railways and to ensure safe movement of trains on more than 10,000 old to very old bridges. And research is required to develop innovative methods for assessing the longitudinal forces and to dissipate these forces without putting much pressure on foundation. After structures, another important discipline of civil engineering is geotechnical engineering. Whatever structure is made on the ground, its weight is borne by the soil, and no structure can stand without a strong foundation. Calgary Tower in Canada stands at 190.8 meter with a total weight of almost 11,000 tons. And out of this 11,000 ton, 6,400 ton is below the ground. The Leaning Tower of Pisa is a typical example of deformation in foundation due to heavy weight of the tower, which was built on soft ground. Today, the major challenge is to make structures that are climate resilient. resilient against landslides, floods and earthquake, because these are natural calamities which cause havoc in the world every year, and challenge is to design a structure that can withstand all these calamities. Community vulnerability and exposure globally increased as a result of unprecedented rate of population growth and a new largely unplanned urbanization development. And another problem before geotechnical engineers is waste disposal. How to make use of waste material which is coming out of the industries and from municipal corporations. It may be hazardous, may be non-hazardous. And similarly, improvement is required in scientific and technical levels in solving geotechnical problems. Hydraulic engineering is also an important subject of civil engineering. Interlinking of river program of Government of India itself is a great challenge to meet. Sediment management, especially on Himalayan system, is the major concern. Navigation through rivers and canals are also being considered at high priority. Scour around piers in different riverbed conditions is another area of research. And Lacey equation, which was given in 1930, was based on available data from a particular type of channel. Characteristics of regime of channel may not be same for all cases, and therefore this is again a matter of research whether Lacey's equation is valid in all conditions of bridge design. Similarly, conservation of groundwater is another challenge. Infrastructure and hazard methods of combining flood damage models with transport models to more fully assess the impact of flooding on society. Providing water for irrigation in all seasons and in all parts of the country is another important challenge. Environmental engineering has grown in a big way, and it has caught the attention of all. Providing drinking water to all is a major challenge in all developing nations, including India. To address the emissions of greenhouse gases and other important carbon containing pollutants is also an important area of research. And it is also important to understand the link between development and health to better connect health outcomes and reduction in risk with ecosystem management and other development interventions. Air, noise and water pollution have become important for all countries, including India. And you will be knowing that sensors in Hawaii recently indicated CO2 concentration in atmosphere, which is around 417 ppm. In 1910, it was 300 ppm. And it took almost 800,000 years to reach to this level of 300 ppm. But it took only 100 years to jump from 300 to 417 ppm. So you can imagine the level of challenge the environmental engineers are facing today. Zero waste industries or no pollution to the river is another important area where lot of research is going on and where lot of technological interventions are required. Now, geomatics engineering has gone sea changes in last couple of years. Earlier it was known as surveying or photography techniques. Now it is called geomatics, and it deals with the modern methods of surveying like UAV, total station, LIDAR, and it has now become a multidisciplinary research including GIS and GPS. Image processing is extremely important, and it is particularly important to write software for processing of images which are indigenous and that can be used in a variety of areas. Now, this is just one example which is on network survey vehicle. This is based on latest survey techniques utilizing laser, GPS and video image processing tools. Now, this is extensively used on monitoring of national highways. It has four cameras, two in the front and two behind. It has a laser profilometer at the front which can determine the roughness. It has GPS system which can record the coordinates of the equipment at regular interval, and all these images are subsequently processed in the laboratory to determine various types of distresses in a pavement. Vehicular pollution has become a major issue nowadays, and it is believed that out of total pollution in a city, almost 17% is coming from vehicles. In one of the studies which was done in Central Roads Institute CRRI New Delhi, it was estimated that only in Delhi we are losing about rupees 48 million per day due to idling of vehicles at signalized intersections. Now you can imagine, when you consider all metropolitan cities in the country, what is the kind of loss. And it is not only the economic loss, the emissions which are coming out of the engine that are creating pollution in the atmosphere. Another important area is transportation engineering. And challenge before transportation engineers today is to provide safe and speedy mobility. That is accessibility of public transport within 1 kilometer of your home. And to design the structures or infrastructure which is disaster and climate resilient. Conservation of natural aggregates is another important area of research. Recycling of material has become now the need of the hour, and use of marginal aggregates, marginal materials in road construction is also of prime importance. Traffic congestion and road safety are major issue in all cities and on non-national highways and state highways. Now, waste utilization for road construction, there are several types of waste which are available in the country, and I have put few of them here, and these figures in the bracket basically indicates the annual production in million tons. And there are several IRC codes which have been framed which allow use of these materials. These materials have been demonstrated extensively in field also, and now the effort is to bring all these materials in main line or mainstream of road construction. Similarly, municipal solid waste in road embankment can be used. And in one of the studies which was conducted by Central Roads Institute in 2016, we found that this can be used as a good material for road embankment after proper segregation and proper drying. The major challenge is these two, drying of this material and segregation, because it is a very heterogeneous material consisting of plastic, cloth, aggregates, metals and many more things. So if you can segregate them, then it is possible to use almost 60 to 65% of this material in road embankment. Now, pavement recycling I have discussed in my another lecture, where sustainable road construction has been discussed, where we can reuse the pavement materials after some processing. I will not go into details of this, but depending upon type of recycling, it can be either cold or hot, or it can be in plant or in place. So there can be four types of recycling processes. Another important consideration in nowadays is to have thin and economic pavements. The basic challenge today before highway engineers is how to economize road construction. And this can be done by making use of geocell. You can reduce the thickness of the pavement by stabilizing the subgrade soil, or by making use of local materials, or by stabilizing the base or sub-base. All these attempts are to either reduce the thickness or to make cheaper roads. When you reduce the thickness of the pavement, basically you are reducing the conservation of, you are reducing the use of natural resources. By making use of industrial waste, again you will be reducing the use of natural hard aggregates or natural soil. So this is a challenge, how to make cheaper and thinner roads. traffic safety is another important challenge before engineers nowadays, and you might be knowing that India is losing almost 146,000 person per year, and which is 10% of world road death. This is the largest number of fatalities in the world, and we are using almost 413 people every day, which is equivalent to crashing of a jumbo jet. And if you just see this in last one decade, average number of death per year in India is 136,118. And I have given here few cities of India which have population less than this: Darjeeling, Anantnag, Greater Noida, Gangtok, Srikakulam, Pathankot, Wardha, Roorkee, Port Blair. All these, so you can imagine that India is losing one city every year. Now this cannot continue for a long time, and now there is a time for action plan to reduce number of fatalities on our roads. And that is the major challenge before highway engineers or before traffic engineers. Traffic safety means basically we have to make our highways which are safer, which are forgiving, and for that we have to do road safety audit to identify the problems on our highway design, to remove the black spots, and also to impart training to create road safety auditors in the country. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways have taken a very bold initiative to allow NIT, IIT and other institutes to run training programs on road safety audit and to create road safety auditors in the country who can take job of auditing of the highways. And we need to have general awareness program in the country on use of helmet, use of seat belt, no mobile, over speeding and so on. There have been several provisions in Motor Vehicle Act of 2019 which can also encourage road safety on our highways. And the government of India has also passed a law which is called Good Samaritan Law, which also will be helpful in reducing the number of death on road. So friends, thank you very much for listening, and if you liked it, please share with your friends, with your colleagues, and do write to me your comments.